Yeah, so today on my drive, I'd like to share my opinions on FIFA and how they fail to stop racism or eradicate racism from world football. And it's funny, you know what I believe, yeah? My opinion is that FIFA is so corrupt and hence their inability to stamp out racism in football. Racism is so easy and can be uprooted from anything and anywhere. You know, if that means you do it through a combination of harsh punishment, imprisonment, bans, and other stuff, then so be it. So for FIFA to tell me that it can't deal with racism, it's shocking and it's an embarrassment. But I don't blame them. It's because there's so much corruption in FIFA that we all know what happened to FIFA back in 2015 when they were arrested for fraud in awarding rights on games, awarding the FIFA World Cup between 2015 and 2010, and so many arrests by the US, somewhere charged, somewhere banned for life from the game and all other stuff. But it is all because nothing has changed from the Blatter era or to this new guy, Infantino or whoever he is there. And they know it. You know what? No amount of words, of slogans, or of t-shirts printed or of banners held before games can stop or kick racism out of football. But that is the first reason. That is because of pure what do you call it? Pure corruption. I think FIFA is one of the most corrupt world bodies in the world, and we know it. It's from facts, not just because I'm saying it, but we've all known what's happened. They act with impunity. It seems like they are at the top, and no one actually really rules them. They don't come under anyone, and they get away with everything. They get away with, man, we all know, awarding the World Cup to Russia, to Qatar, and everything that came out of it. There is just so much corruption in that place. And when there is corruption, people who are corrupt, like FIFA, they don't think about anything. They don't think about what their actions or inactions do to other people, how it hurts other people or kills other people. But we are talking about a whole race here. Because let's face it, 100%, it's a fact that every racism in football comes from whites to blacks. But I just don't get it. Come to think of it, it is a crime anywhere to what do you call it? To be racist and to do racist stuff to people, like throwing bananas onto field and stuff. You can never do that at any workplace, man. You can never in this teenage, in this modern world, throw bananas at people, call them monkeys, and do stuff at any workplace. So why the little brain of FIFA thinks that it's okay for that to happen to black people in their workplace, on the football field as players? It just beats me. I just don't get it. But then I keep saying it. It is so simple to do that and to eradicate it. But all FIFA thinks about is the money that they are making. That if they ban a team, if they ban a country, if they ban a people, now it's even seeping down to players on the football field doing it. Recently, was it a player from Rangers? Yeah, who was on the receiving end from another player from wherever, the Czech Republic or something. And then this has resulted in fines and other stuff. But man, this is shocking to think that in our world, in our kind of modern world, that these things can be happening and be going on, and we don't seem to care about it. It's happening in Europe. Europe is a disgrace when it comes to football racism. It's happening in England. England, it's a big thing in England. It's a massive thing in England. It's happening in England. It's happening in Italy. Italy is another worst place. And then Spain. Man, and in Spain, it's even coming from players. You know, there are Spanish players who are saying stuff to black players, like, you black shit. But one thing I don't really get about racism, Why is it that every time you have a fight, you pick up a fight with a white person, they are so small-minded that they have to insult your color? You can pick a fight with a white person, and you are probably strongly insulting them about their big head or their small nose or something, and then all they can think about is insult you by your color. I just don't get it. So you are fighting with another player on the football field. You can just say to him, "Yeah, you little piece of shit." Why do you have to say you black shit, you black piece of shit? I just don't get it. But then is it because they are so frustrated? Is it because, I don't know, what is it about a black man that pisses them off so much that they always have to insult your color? I just don't get it. And for the fact that we black people are so happy in our own skin that we never insult other people by their color, it baffles me that a white man up until this century is still not that comfortable in their skin that they have to insult you, another person, by your skin. But then that's not even the point. Today I'm not here to share my opinions on racism. Today I'm here to really share my opinions on just FIFA and the fact that it failed. Man, it's happening everywhere, in Hungary, in countries, Slovakia, in countries who are not even known to be good footballing nations. They are all now into racism, and the only reason probably their football is now even on the app, like their leagues are now probably on the app, is just because of these same black players who have flooded those countries and helping them, you know, the Belarusian leagues and those places, to help their leagues to grow up a bit. So you have these Brazilians traveling there, you have these Africans, you know, traveling there. Russia is another one. Well, for the Russians, they've always never played by the books. But like I said, all football, every football comes under FIFA. Be it at national level or every FA in the world falls under FIFA. So so the Italian FA, the British, UK FA, all these FAs, Spanish FAs, and they are all failing. And they are failing because the top, you know, the father of all football in the world is the one failing. And it is sad that this thing is happening like everywhere, all across, in the top leagues, in the middle leagues, in the bottom leagues, even in kids football. And you're wondering how long can we live like this? If anyone says that you can't stop racism in football, that is one big lie. You know, I'm on this platform, we don't really encourage swearing or name calling, so I can't really really swear, but I don't know what words I can use to describe the failure of FIFA to correct this anomaly in football. You can't just bring us the beautiful game and think that you won't deal with the consequences that the beautiful game generates. You get me? So if you are happy to bring us the beautiful game and you are happy to make all the money that the beautiful game generates, then you should be happy as well to deal with whatever baggage, you know, whatever baggage that the beautiful game results in, or whatever consequences comes out of the action of providing the beautiful game and making so much money out of it. So it is shocking that this continues to happen. And don't get me wrong, if anyone says that they can't root out racism in football, that person is a big liar. It is so simple and it is so easy that you know what? What I would have loved to see is that FIFA can come out and say, we are confident that we've uprooted racism from football, and now it's all shifted to social media because over there we don't have any powers over there to control it. So it's out of our hand. But no, you know what? This is happening everywhere. It's happened so much that we even don't want to even discuss what happens on social media. It is the ones that physically happens at stadiums, on the football field. Look at a recent game played between PSG and was it Besiktas or something? Or no. Some football team in Turkey, Galatasaray or something like that. When they had to stop the game, PSG and the other team had to walk off from that game because this racism had come from a match official. you know what? Yeah, FIFA, man, FIFA. So, you know, for some of us, we've proposed that, you know what? Black people in the world, and move away, you know, cut away from FIFA and what do you call it? And find their own or make, you know, make their own association, like Federation of Black International Football Association or Federation of Black Football Association. That would be their world body that would run their affairs for them, because you can't be part of a group that really do not want you, you know. So if you are part of a group that doesn't want you, like a world governing body, you move away, you cut away, and you fix your own, you establish your own, that's the word, establish. So you establish your own world body that would regulate your affairs for you and your football for you. And you know, it's always simple and natural and well known that blacks everywhere are so welcoming. So when they establish such a world governing body, they can then open it up to anyone. Anyone can join it. You can be white, you can be black, you can be brown, no matter what your color, you can always join it. All they ask that you respect other people, because if you don't, then you just be kicked out of the association. And it's so simple, and it can be done. Why FIFA has failed to do this, it's just beyond me. I just can't get it. But like I said, it just stems from the fact that they are just a corrupt organization. Because if you are not a corrupt organization, these are simple things that you can do, you know. These are just simple things. Man, you just cannot be racist in any workplace in the world. So why does FIFA think that it is okay for black footballers in their line of work as footballers to suffer racism? It's unbelievable. Every black player that you speak to in Europe or anywhere around the world, apart from, say, Africa and Brazil, has faced racism before. It is shocking. But meanwhile, as I speak to you, there are so many white players in Africa, and they can never tell you that they face any racism, because we just love people. Black people are just loving. It's unbelievable. So the fact that we can love everyone, and then we just face hate everywhere we go to, it's just shocking. But man, I don't get it. So what is FAs can say? What is British FAs and other white country, white dominated FAs will say is that, yeah, why not move back to your motherland, to Africa or somewhere where, yeah, black players are okay. But oh yeah, they can say that. But what I say back to them is that, you know, that is what the world is. The world is now a globalized country. Everything is so small now, a global economy. People move around and take jobs everywhere. There are so many white people working nice and comfortably in Africa. There are so many white people, so many international organizations, NGOs, who employ people, white people from Europe and the Americas and everywhere. And they are feeling bash. No, they are feeling okay. They are feeling very, very, very well. They are enjoying Africa and other places that they work in, because they don't face any racism. They are free to live their life and to make decisions. You know, and it's not that the other way is not correct it's not true for black and other ethnic minorities working around these countries. So it is FIFA's corruption. FIFA is very, very corrupt. And like I said, when you are that corrupt as a person or as an institution, you don't really care what your corrupt nature does to other people and how it affects them. All you think about is the money that you are making and the money that you are going to lose if you were to take action. So I'm now saying to FIFA today that no amount of words, no number of t-shirts with slogans printed on them, kick racism out of football, is going to help anyone, and it's going to stop the racism. You have to start from everywhere and call out people. I've already discussed this about the British press, some of the most racist press in the world. It's happening everywhere. In Germany, racism in football against black players, it's just shocking. But the question I have for FIFA though is that if the coin were to turn the other way, if the case was to be turned the other way, if it was blacks perpetrating this crime to white people, would they have sorted the problem out? Is it because it's this way that they think it's normal and they don't have to do anything about it? They are black players who are traumatized, you know, on the field and after leaving the field. Man, it's shocking. Just think of the psychological damage that is doing to them. They have families, they have wives that they go home to, they have kids. And just like in any other line of work where racism is not entertained, you just can't allow that to continue to happen. So FIFA, I'm saying today on opinions that you, as a very, very corrupt outfit, you know that racism is not allowed in football. You know you can deal with it, but you fail to deal with it. Anyway, that is where I end this piece on FIFA and its corruption and the fact that it's refusing to deal directly with racism in football. I want FIFA to know that black players are suffering a lot in football, and it is so easy. If racism is not accepted or allowed in any workplace, then make sure that you uproot it. Ban people, ban players, ban fans for life, so they have nothing else to do with football. They can hide on social media and do their stuff. No one cares. If someone insults me on social media, I don't care because I'm not seeing the person. But if someone is right in front of me, I'm in a stadium. Man, in Italy, it's just crazy, shocking. The Balotellis, who are these Ghanaian players? There are some Ghanaian players who, Sule Muntari and all those people. And a lot of them took stands, you know. Sule Muntari, for instance, was so pissed off on one game, he was not going to play. And then you see referees that even making the whole thing worse, white referees as such, then showing these black players who are complaining about racism chants from the crowds or from fellow players, and then they intend showing them red cards or yellow cards, like wanting them to say, shut up, you are not allowed to talk about it. Man, this is just shocking. Anyway, man, I'm out of here. You know how we do it on opinions. We just say it how it is. We say what we are thinking. We say it in a humble way, in a respectful way. We don't curse. We don't speak falsehood. Every corruption that I quoted for FIFA are all facts. You can verify them. Go and look on the internet or anywhere. Read the newspapers back in 2015 up all the way until 2010. You could see exactly what happened with bans, with the stuff that came following the football award, FIFA World Cup award awarded to Russia and other places. And then the CONSAFA Cup held in the US in 2016 or something. These are all there. And FIFA is a very, very corrupt unit. So yeah, until the next time, stay positive, keep doing the right things, and always remember, your actions hurt other people. So put your comments down below. If you think you love listening to our opinions on issues, just subscribe to opinions and we'll bring you more on what we think about things and other stuff. Stay positive.